Hello guys, this is day 5 after I hacked me Advantage Cyber 2, and let's get started. So this is the room which will deal with SQL injection, and the topic is someone's stolen Santa's gift list. And okay, let's get started. So firstly, they want us to access the website on this place. This is the place where they want us to access, and this is the website which is here. Now let's start with our very first question, which is, where is it? Yeah. So without using directory brute forcing, what is Santa's secret login panel? So firstly, this just involves random guessing, and this doesn't require any tool and all they want actually to use. And they have even given us a hint that what could be Santa's secret login page. So according to this, I think it could be Santa panel, where it says secret login panel. So it's just a random guess for it to be Santa panel, and that's it. That's right. So using brute force, so what it did, Santa panel, and that's right. So without using brute force, what is Santa's secret login panel? Now the second question is, visit Santa's secret login page and bypass using SQL injection. So in this page, to use SQL injection, since I do not know the username, dash or 1 equal to 1 dash dash, and again here dash or 1 equal to 1 dash dash. Okay, so I log in and I'm in. So what actually happened is, also I'll explain you, is that there was some kind of condition which was over here. They actually explained it over here, but I'll just go it with once more. So for example, this is the condition which they have put over here. Now using this dash or true dash dash, rather than true, I have written 1 equal to 1, which equals to true. So what will happen is that select username password from user, where, so everything is fair till this point, and this is where our input comes here. Okay, so where username is equal to, and our input will be equal to dash or 1 equal to 1. So that will kind of break it, and thus we'll be able to access it. So just like this, we kind of did our input and we went in. So see, just like this, it will replace this, and just for the password part as well. So both of these conditions will become true and will go inside. And for a better explanation of this, I'll provide a link in the description where I've totally and like explained how this happens with respect to a proper table and all. So yeah, you can refer that as well. Now how many entries are there in the gift database? So this looks like a place for gift database. So let me search my name. I don't think there would be an entry, so let me just put a random digit and let me search it again. Okay, so I do get some values. So I don't know on what basis it is searching, but I can indeed notice that all of these have a A in their name. The gifts part, all of them have A as a character in their name. Okay, so how many are there? So I need to know each and every of this gift, because it says how many entries are there in the whole database. So let's see that. So what should I do? Okay, so select all the entries whose name is, where it is a condition, right? That select where the name is equal to whatever I enter. So for example, I enter the name B. So all the entries which have B as a character. So now let's break that. So all the entries which have break, then again or 1 equal to 1 dash dash. So it will become select all from all the directories, like it will become like this. Let me quite write it. It will become like select select. It will come select all from all the, like, tape from that table which was there, like gift table. Maybe the name is gift and not as the name of the table. So gift table, where I was putting in the name of the gift, right? So where gift is equal to, and now I'm breaking it, like this will part will break. So where this gift is equal to nothing, which is wrong, or 1 equal to 1 dash dash. So this is OR condition. So even though this is false, but this is true. So this true, false and true OR will become true. So select all from gifts where true. So that means select all from gifts. So everything from that gift table will run. Alright, so let me search this. And yep, I have all the results. So let me count this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. I think there are 22. I might have missed maybe. And that was alright. And what did Paul ask for? So, Paul, here is Paul. He asked for a GitHub ownership. Cool. And that is done as well. And what is the flag? Okay, now for the flag part, we will have to get each and every value of each and every table. This is just one table containing two columns. So I need each and everything. So I need to find a point which is like SQL vulnerable. As you can see, this point is vulnerable to SQL injection. See? So since this point is vulnerable to SQL injection, let's use SQL map over here. So firstly, we need to open Burp Suite and let us configure Burp Suite. So to configure, either you can use Foxy Proxy or you can just, so you can use Foxy Proxy or like me, you can go down all the way to your settings and do it to manual configuration, keeping everything as same. Okay, so kind of Burp Suite is on right now. Let me turn the interceptors on and let me again search for the name AAA, or let me search for GitHub and let me search it. So this request came over here. Okay, and let me not, okay, now let me turn. Okay, now what will I do with this request is that I'll right click on it and I'll save it. See, so this is how you do it. So firstly, let me save it to the music directory. Yeah, so I'll save it. I'll click on this. I'll click save item and I'll give it a name req and I'll save it. And it has been successfully saved to home a music rec. And now I don't need the Burp Suite anymore. I can just close it. And again, going back, changing everything back to normal. So what I wanted is here, I have this rec request, and if I'll just cat it out, we'll be able to see how it looks. So this is the request which was there, and in this request we were actually putting the value where we putting this GitHub value. You see this GitHub, this was our value, this is the one which we put. So you can also see that over here only. Let's see, it is a point vulnerable to SQL injection. That's all right. So okay, so now we have the request. Now whenever you have a request like this, so you can even use this in a post form, even though this is a get and this is like much better and easier. So now let's how you use that is, firstly let's use SQL map dash h. So these are all the things which you need to do. Okay, so the first thing I tried is SQL map dash r. Is whenever you have a file like a Burp Suite file, you need to provide the tag dash r and then the name of the file. So since I'm already in that directory which contains the file, so this will kind of load and load and load, and it will give us some value. Okay, let me clear this out and let me show you all my stuff which I did. So okay, let's just run it. Okay, so let's see. So it is testing for different types of parameters. Like it tested for MySQL database, maybe it did not get anything. PostgreSQL search, it didn't get anything. MySQL search, it didn't get anything. And it's just going and going. So one thing if you will notice over here is that, okay, let it just run it. Yeah, so first error which you see over here is that if union based SQL injection is not detected, please consider usage of this option, do this thing, and yeah, this is the critical warning which I would like you to pay attention to. It says that all tested parameters do not appear to be injectable. Try to increase values for level. So that means I am increasing I am trying to use more dangerous commands by increasing the risk, which I don't want to do. But if you suspect that there is some kind of protection mechanism involved, maybe you can try using --- tamper equal to like this thing. So again, if you will clearly notice in our this question sheet, they have clearly given us that Santaga had installed a web application firewall WAF, and we need to write this command in order to bypass it. Okay, so let me clear this out. So now this was there. Now to an addition of this will be this command. Okay, now when I'll run this, so this was our first thing. Just ignore that dump all for right now. Just ignore it. Yeah, so it gave me the same result. So the first critical warning gave me the idea that I need to use this. That's all right. So ignore this. We are nice till this point. Okay, so we are all good till this point. Now this thing I ran, and when I ran this thing, again I got an errors and warnings that says that the get parameter search does not seem to be injectable, and if union based SQL query is not detected, please consider forcing the backend DBMS. So they are telling me to force the backend DBMS. So I need to find out what is the DBMS, which database is it running. So to find out that part, I'll use --DBS. Okay, so this part SQL map -r is to use that request file, --tamper is to bypass the firewall, --DBS to know which database is running on. Okay, so that I can use, then I can maybe use that database. So I use the, now again I use this --DBS, and I click on enter, and this is all the results which I get. And clearly it says the backend database is SQLite. So now we clearly know what the backend is. So now when we know the backend, I'll just show you SQL map -h. Now once you know the DBS, and even the hint was not hint, the warning was saying us that I need to provide force the backend DBS to a provided value. So again I do what as they say --DBMS. I use that. And now I have SQL map -r request this thing --DBMS SQLite. Okay, now you can see one addition of this tables. The word tables, what tables will do is that it will enumerate database tables. Okay, so it did enumerate all the tables and it gave me this. And again, one more thing, if you'll notice here, when I was just using --DBS, that it shows that on SQLite it is not possible to enumerate databases, use only --tables. So I use --tables. Alright, and now we know that they have three tables with 1, 2, and 3. Okay, so that's cool. We have name of the three tables. So what we should actually do is that we should provide the value --T and like --T name of the table. For example, let me name it as, let me use users table, and then I should use --columns to get all the columns. So this is how it should be done, like slowly, and it will just give me the value in that table, one specific table. But what I actually did, okay, let's see if it even works. Okay, I'm not sure. Okay, I did work. Okay, great. So as you can see, I just got the answer for one table. This is not what you want. So what I did, just as for fast shortcut something, that I did --dump all. This is the command which I was using from the start. what will happen in dump all is that it will dump everything, and it is there in the start only in the, okay, I'll just find maybe, yeah, here it is. Where is it? Yeah, here it is. Dump all the DBMS database table entries. So it will dump everything, and that is exactly what I wanted. And I just ran that and I got the results. I got this table, which is James and all these name of the people, which we saw in here. In here, when we use that space or 1=1 space, yeah. So this table is the same as this one. Where is it? Is the same as this one where we got that. And this is another tables which we were not able to see previously, but now we are able to see it because we are using SQL map, which will automate and all help us do stuff. So what is the flag? So this is flag is actually in the hidden table. So it has three tables, right? It had three tables, remember? So one table, two table, and this is the third big table. So the flag is here. And what is admin's password? So admin's password is this one. Okay, a very weird password, but yeah, that's it. So I hope you like this video. Like, share, subscribe, and I'll just go through it one more time, start to end. SQL map dash r req for the burp suit part, dash dash this thing, tamper to escape firewall, dash dash dump all to remove everything, and dash dash dbms, even remember the s, SQL, so that all of this could perform better. Like, I have forced the backend, I know some information, so that's great. So yeah, like, share, subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Bye bye.